Hey, good morning, how do you do? We've got something special for you. It's just for fun, it's just for kids. Time for the Sydney Sessions.
All right, number six, if you've got an extra $2,000 and nothing better to do with your money, you could buy a pair of these. Ooh, Balenciaga reptile sneakers.
Yeah, they're ugly.
Those are awful.
They're available now in retail for $1,890. The proportions are exaggerated because they're Balenciaga, so of course they are. The most interesting thing about them, besides the price, they curve upwards.
Yeah.
So let's hope you don't have super long toes.
Yeah.
You know, the ones that are so long they look like fingers, because that would be uncomfortable. But that's the price you pay for fashion.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's like they're trying to make it as ugly as they can. Mm. Mm.
Number five, someone texted us asking, why are we seeing so many ladybugs right now? So we did a little research. Here's your answer. According to ladybug scientists, ladybugs, otherwise known as lady beetles, are looking for winter homes right now.
Oh, but they are.
The weather is unusually warm this time of year, but it is getting cooler, so they're on the hunt for places to hibernate. On warm autumn days, you're likely to see lots of ladybugs in sunny areas in your yard, and chances are the ladybugs you're seeing are likely non-native Asian lady beetles. Hmm. Look closely, you might see more spots and an M-shape marking on their heads. Their population has increased due to an increase in soybean aphids in the area, and that's their main source of food.
Oh, the aphids.
So do they go away for the winter, or?
They hibernate, they lock down, they stay in, just like Robin. Just stay in all, watch Netflix.
Except mine's year-round, the hibernation. Yeah.
Interesting. Yeah. All right, time for number four. Flirting is fun. Well, it can be, but if you've already got a partner, there's no need to flirt with other people. It's not going to end well for you.
How you doing?
If you're already married or you're romantically involved with someone, relationship scientists say that if you're seeking the attention of other people, you should look inward. Mm. Take a long, hard look at yourself and your current situation. Maybe you're not with the right person, or subconsciously, you're trying to drive them away. If you need constant attention, you might be a narcissist. Mm. And that's a whole other issue. But if you're only flirting to get a rise out of someone, it's not fair, and it's cruel, so stop it or break up and flirt with anyone that you want to. Now, if you're intrigued by all of this, you can read more about it in the Journal of Sex.
Oh, there you go.
It's an excellent read. We haven't promoted the Journal of Sex before.
Well,
yeah, Google that.
Good luck. Our number three, it does not seem like it right now, but winter is quickly approaching. So here is an idea to keep you warm, relaxed, and refreshed. How about a portable home steam sauna box? The one-piece tent has a side door that zips open and shut. It's easy to install in your home or apartment. You can also take it down when you're done with your sauna experience. It comes with a steam generator, a chair, footrest, and mat. This one's on Amazon, $129.
What a steal.
But there are hundreds of options out there if you're looking for something similar. And they say easy to assemble, so there you go. Mm. Good luck.
All right, number two, the list of haunted places in Illinois continues today. We're talking about the Stickney Mansion. It's located in Bull Valley, Illinois, in McHenry County, about 2 hours from Chicago.
Oh, look at that.
Stickney Mansion is far off the beaten path in a secluded area along a mostly deserted highway. George and Sylvia Stickney built the house in the 1800s. They'd like to have seances and conjure spirits, and they made sure it had no square corners because they believed that the spirits got caught in the corners. Dopey, dopey spirits. Well, according to legend, the architect messed up and left one area with a 90-degree corner, and that's reportedly where George Stickney was found dead.
Lord have
mercy. Oh, boy.
Doctors said it was heart failure, but others believed it was the work of angry ghosts.
Yeah.
It was murder. It is believed George Stickney haunts the house along with other spirits.
Does someone live there? Can you do tours of the place? Well, I need to know more.
So ghosts can defy the laws of physics, but they can't get out of a corner. That's
It's tricky. It's very tricky.
Ghosts are really complex.
Yes. Yeah, they are.
All right, number one, if you've got a problem, maybe we can solve it. This is from Lynn. She says, I have a tattoo with my ex-boyfriend's name on it. It's on my left forearm. He passed away unexpectedly 10 years ago.
All right.
I love having a small reminder of him that's always with me. I'm engaged to a wonderful person now. He doesn't mind the tattoo, but he recently asked if I'd consider covering the tattoo or wearing a long sleeve wedding dress to please his family. He said they'd be more comfortable without seeing it on our wedding day, especially his mom. They're good people, I like them a lot, but honestly, I've never covered my tattoo before. What should I do now? Oh boy, that's a tricky one.
That is tricky.
If he was that meaningful to you, do you need it carved in your skin for the rest of your life?
Or maybe she got it before he died.
I know, but I'm saying it's like...
Do you think she should get it removed?
You could get it removed. I'm just saying, she's, he's so meaningful to me, but isn't he meaningful even if you get rid of the tattoo? Isn't he still meaningful?
Yeah. Right.
If he's that meaningful, isn't he in your brain? Do you need a reminder of it on your forearm?
It's also a sign of insecurity of her current
spouse. It ain't like he's coming back to steal her away.
Right.
No, I think it may be less about...
Unless she stays at the Stickney Mansion.
Yeah. You think it's
The bigger concern isn't that whether he likes it or not, it's that he's trying to keep his mother happy.
Yes, he's too
He's trying to get her to accommodate
the mother.
Little
mama's boy.
And that's where the trouble will be.
Yep.
A lot of red flags. We could really
Can't be 38 years old worrying about what your mommy thinks.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
That's the problem.
Well, that's a 666. Maybe we'll follow up. Maybe this person will
Let us know what you decide.
Scott! Wow.